Hello everyone with the spirit of learning. Thank you very much for coming back to my YouTube channel. My name is Angga Rizky, and now we're gonna learn how to design and code for the mobile development in the Android Studio and the Adobe XD. Today's video, we're gonna learn how do we implement the promo code in the e-commerce for the mobile application. So basically, after user has bought their own items in our mobile application, we might suggest them to use our promo code to get the cheaper price. So that's why right now we're gonna learn how do we use XML and Java for the animation and for the validation of the promo code. Okay everyone, with the speed of learning, as usually you have to download those assets in the video's description, because we're gonna learn together right away. Alright, so let's get started. Hello everyone, so welcome to my desktop. This is Spirit of Learning background, and as I said earlier that I have been designing with the Adobe XD. This is simple design, but it's quite beautiful, isn't it? So if you wanna see the how it works, so basically this is my checkout page with 6 items, but it's just dummy, actually just 3 items, and we have to use the promo code over here, and this is Gogoanga, and we have to check first whether it's working or not. And if it's working, it's gonna be like this. Wow, amazing, right? So let's try again. Promo code, check, and boom. Cool. Alright. Well, let's get started to working on this. And I have provided the assets that you have already downloaded. But I'm still missing one item here. Sorry, 2 items for the font type. So this is the font type that we're gonna use, Montserrat Light and Montserrat Regular, that we're gonna copy into our project, which is, so you have to go to Android Studio project, and after that find your own Android Studio project. So this is Jajan Cart. Where is that Jajan Cart? This one. And you have to go to App and SRC and Main, and over here you just need to create another directory that we call assets, and another one we call fonts. Okay, because the reason why we have to customize font, it has to be beautiful as well, like the way I did in the Adobe XD. So this is the pick number 1 and 3, because I don't have any picture yet, so we have to use a drawable on it. So just okay here and okay. Okay, and the next one we have to go to layout, which is activity underscore main dot xml. So I have to based on my emulator, and then after that we'll go to values and styles, and over here we have to replace by no action bar. Okay, all right like this, and we're gonna remove this first. I think that I'm gonna remove it. Okay. And then the next one is I wanna change the color of top, so I'm going to use this color as a green one. Just copy the hex code, and we have to go to colors here, color primary drag. We're gonna replace them with the new hex code here, 1AA6BX. Okay, this one. And if you see in the design, there's, you know, like a gradient, but I'm pretty sure that I'm able to make it by a few here. So just use few, I think. Few, and this is match pattern. And for the height, I think I go with 170 dp. Okay. And for the background, just go with the sample one. But we have to customize, because this is the gradient color, you know. So we have to a background header. Okay. So this is, it has to be a shape, because we're going to draw something here. So the first one is a gradient. So the start color, we have to setting the start color. If we see in the Adobe XD, the first color is has to be this one. Okay, just copy, and then the end of color, we have to get another one. Okay, all right cool. Okay, and I think that we just need to replace this one, which is a background header, and we did it. Cool. But I think that this is supposed to be bigger, and just go with 180. Yeah, it's nice. And don't forget to setting margin right, and then left, and then top, because we are using constraint layout. So I think that we have to change it to the 0 and 0 and 0. Okay, and after that, after view, we have to make the text view, you know, for the title. So just go with a row content and row content, and the text size has to be 22 sp, and text color has to be white color, and the text itself has to be a my checkout. Okay, and I think that we have to put here at the below. Okay, cool, right? And I think that we have to give the ID title. Sorry, I think here supposed to be jajan title. Okay, the reason why I have to give the ID, it's because we're gonna customize this font style with the Java. Okay, and we have to put in the middle, in the middle of night. Okay, and I want to give about maybe 24, yeah, just like this. And we need another text view over here, so I think that we just want to duplicate this text view. As you can see, I just duplicate them, and don't forget to change the IDs to jajan subtitle, and this is for the text, 3 items based on this one. And then we're gonna customize this font style later on in the Java. Okay. Okay, so right now we're heading to the Java to customize that font. Okay, over here, this is a Java. And if you see, there's another folder which we called assets. And this is supposed to be text view and jajan title, and like this. Okay. And after that, we heading to jajan title, which is text view, and find RID jajan title. Okay. And I have provide the script. So this is for the M like. Okay. And this is supposed to be M like. Okay. And after that, we just want to duplicate this for M regular. And this is for the M regular. Okay. And after that, we provide here set typeface. So if we see in the Adobe XD, for jajan title has to be a regular. So M regular. Okay. So if you see right now, the title has changed with the another font type, you know. So you have to follow for the jajan subtitle also, because we're gonna passing with the Montserrat like over here. Yeah, it looks amazing. Okay, so let's go ahead. So for this one, we're planning to use a linear layout. So we'll just go to Android Studio, and then after that, below of the text view, we write a linear layout like this, and this is transparent and this is row content. Okay, and after that, we have to give the orientation to the vertical, and then if you see here, we got the, you know, wait, padding, sorry, margin, and this is supposed to be margin either. Okay, so I think that I just want to give a padding top 20 dp. Okay, like that. And then after that, you just want to give the background first, the temporary background. Okay, and then give the margin right about, let me check again, 16 dp. And then margin left is about 16 dp. Okay, and give the margin right and margin left. Oh, sorry, I think that for this linear layout, we just need to give the margin start and margin end, which is we could refresh them with a 16 dp. okay, it looks cool. Okay, now we just want to move under of three items and give the margin like this about 32. That's fine, and we have to zoom to see it clearly. Okay, looks nice. And the thing that we have to do is just want to writing this another linear layout for this section. Okay, so this is a linear layout that we could use another mesh parent, and this is for the wrap content. Okay, and we have to divide 1, 2, and 3. So I think that for the orientation has to be a horizontal, and then after that we have to give the margin left and right, which is 16 dp, and margin right is 16 dp. okay, and let's go ahead with the image view first. I think that I could go with about 60 dp, sorry, about 70. We just want to copy this and src pick one. Okay, oh, I think that it's too big, so I can go with 50, but it's to be so small. So the problem is the asset that I provide to you is not a high resolution, so it's okay. You might have to replace them with another asset that you might have. So I have to go to background header and copy this background header, and then we have to provide another drawable background items. Okay, so in the background items we don't need to use a gradient. Instead of using gradient, we have to use solid. So for the color itself has to be white color, but we have to give the corner here a radius about 11 dp. yeah, and then we could replace this a background white with the background items. Boom. Okay, right now we have the corner for the smooth radius for the corners. And then after image view, we have to provide another linear layout, of course, here, that we just wrap content and wrap content. And then for the orientation, we could go with the vertical. Okay, and I'm going to copy the checkout, the title of checkout here. Absolutely, we have to copy both of them, and we have to put inside of this linear layout. Okay, and then we have to give different ID. I think that for the title is item title 1, and this is item subtitle 1. Okay, and after that we just need to remove this and remove this like this. Okay, and then try again to remove them. Okay, and after that I have to change the color first so I'm able to see properly here. So this is for the text color, and the secondary color is supposed to be BBB. Okay, and in the image view we have to give the margin right, which is 14 dp. okay, and after that we need another button. If you see over there, there's the remove button. Wow, looks small but useful, right? So I think that I just want to put that button here after the linear layout. So just draw the button here. For the width, I think just go with a 16 dp, and then for the height I just go with 22 dp. okay, but it looks small. Yeah, just go with 35, and width just go with 100 20. No. Too long. Yeah, okay, 18. And the text supposed to be remove. And text size 11 SP. Okay. And then text color. If we see in the text color, we see that a different color, you know. So just go with this. And we have to go back to the background items, copy, and then we have to provide another drawable for the background button remove. Okay. So in this background, we have to give the solid, but the corner has to be 200 dp, and the solid color, we're gonna copy them over here. And boom, okay. So we have to replace the background with the background button remove. Okay, amazing. And then we're gonna move this button. Just pause. How do we move it? Yeah. Oh wait. Let me give this the. So first of all, I have to give them 100 TP. No. 180. Okay. And then I have to give the margin right, which is 10 DP. Okay, cool. So for the button itself, I have to give the margin top, you see, 10 DP. 5. Okay. Alright, it looks nice. Let me check again here. Okay, solid, and yeah, it looks amazing. Cool. And I think that for the text size has to be 13. Yeah. And yeah, I'm gonna preview it first in the emulator. And I guess that the button is just too big. So we have to decrease again. Maybe 30. And then for the width itself, maybe 70. Okay. And increase the margin top to the 7 dp. Alright. Looks amazing. And we have to change this, don't forget. Martabak P. Okay. And the price IDR. Yeah. Just write whatever you want, and don't forget to custom this font style in the Java. So this is let me give the edit button remove one. Okay, so we have to go to Java to customize the font style. So I already declare another variable here for the item title one, if you see here. Item title 1, and then for the button itself, but the problem is the remove, it doesn't enough, you know. And I think that I just want to increase layout width to the 80, like this. And then after that, I'm gonna try again. Okay, if you see here, it's perfectly right. So I think that we just want to repeat the last step that we did for another item here, right? Okay, so we're back to the Android. Okay, so over here I got martabak and the second item and the last one. Okay, but if you see the font type is different because I haven't changed it, so you have to change the ID. This is number 3 and then number 2 and so on. Okay, so we have to go to main activity Java here to customize the font type. So right now the font has changes and it nice, right? So the thing that we have to do, if you see in the design, there's, you know, like the ornament of the design that make it more touchable and eye-catching, you know. So I think that we have to make like that, you know. With I think that we are able to use view in there. Okay. So after the three items, the last one, we have to give you. I think that I prefer like to go with a match parent, and for the height, just go with a 4dp. Okay. And for the background, I don't remember the hex code. I'm sorry. I just want to copy here. So 1AAB. Okay. So if you see that, that view is nice, right? But the problem is, it doesn't look like smooth, you know, just like, you know, smooth. And I think that I go with a 6dp. Okay. So are we able to make in a drawable? Let's get started first. A background, a border. Okay. So we have to go to button remove, and then we have to go to here. So here, can we just radius? Oh yeah, bottom left radius have to be like this, and bottom right radius have to be like this, 1AA6B. Wait, I forgot again. Forgive me. 6B8. Okay. And we just need to replace this with the background border. And it's supposed to be working. Yeah, it is. Look, guys, look what we did here. Wow, amazing, right? Now I'm gonna test in the emulator. Okay, so here is this. It looks nice, but it's just too big. I can go with a 4dp instead. Okay, so the next one, actually that you just need to duplicate this layout and then remove all of those content. Okay, let me show you. So this is the linear layout that we did, right? This one. Right, and then we just need to copy this until right here. Yeah, we have to copy this until right here, and then just a duplicate here. And then first of all, you have to remove the item. So actually, you don't need the item here until right here. Okay, and then after that, you have to move it, right? So we have to go to design and select in this section, and then move it. Just remove this, select this and remove. Wait, oh, this one. So I wanna remove this, please. And then after that, you're heading to in this section, which is datum. Okay, and give the top one maybe a 24dp, no, just go with the 16. Okay, and after that, the thing that you have to do is prepare this one. You can copy from this, right? So this linear layout has to be, the orientation has to be horizontal. Okay. So then after that, you just need to copy from here. Copy. And then put here. Like this. Okay. You see that? And this is supposed to be vertical. And this is transparent. The problem is, if we make it horizontal, the view become like this. So it has to be a vertical. Like this, and then after that, for this one, I think that we just need to make another linear layout here. So let me prepare linear layout, and then match parent, and then this is block content, and this is supposed to be horizontal. Okay, like this. Okay, looks nice, right? And for the margin left, supposed to be 16dp. And margin right supposed to be 16dp, like this. Okay, it looks nice. And this is the title. I think that we just need to price title, and then here supposed to be price subtitle. Okay, but let me move it over here. Okay, so if you see in the design, the text view is different place, you know. So this is supposed to be total price, and this is, you have to write maybe like, you know, ADR. Wow, so expensive, huh? And in the view, you have to give the margin top 20 dp. Okay, cool. And yeah, you just need to duplicate this linear layout, copy, and you see there's another linear layout, but this is for the discount. So we have to change price with the discount and change the price with a discount at all. Okay, and this is supposed to be discount. Oops, discount, and then this one has to be a 0%. Okay, and I'm going to give the margin right over here. Maybe just go with margin right. Where is margin right? Oh, I already have this one, so just go with a 16, maybe 26. Okay, amazing. So I'm gonna try into the emulator, but first of all, you have to register this variable to over here to customize the font style. So this is the total price that I just edit in the Java for customized font style. Wow, it's quite big enough. There's a lot of text field, and I think that I'm gonna find the easiest way to customize this font style, you know. Alright, so let's go back to the design. We need this one, and I think that it doesn't cover enough, you know, the space itself, but let's try first. So the thing that we have to do, we have to copy this linear layout. Okay, copy, and then we have to put here, and after that, for another linear layout that inside of this linear layout, we're gonna remove them and change it with the edit text. Okay, this is match parent, and this is 55 dp. Okay, and then give the margin right, which is a 16 dp, and margin left a 16 dp, and padding left a 16 dp, sorry, maybe 12. Okay, and then you see that there's another edit text, and if we see in the design, we have to select this and then put below of this. Okay, we remove this and then got this one, and it has to be 16. But the problem is right now the design is not enough, but if I did here, it's enough. Wow, how can? All right I think that it's because we have to move to the 16, and this one also we have to decrease by a 16. Okay, so then there's another space here, but it's not really cool, and I think that this is supposed to be 8, and this is supposed to be 8. Okay, so we just need to give space for the button over here. Rather than use 8, how about we just go with 10. Okay, and this one we can go with 10 dp. Okay, alright and this is supposed to be 16. Yeah, cool. And yeah, if you see in the design in the Adobe XD, this one has to be a customization. So we have to go to a drawable. I think that we just want to copy from this one, copy, No. From button remove. Okay, this one we copy, and then new drawable resource for background input promo. Okay, and in this section, we need to change the color. We need to give the border, which is stroke, and for width 1 dp, and the color is fff just for the temporary. Okay, we'll go back to the HD, and the fill color or solid color that we called in the Android, and this is for the border color. Okay, and then we have to give maybe 11 dp. Okay, cool. So in the edit text, we give them a background, which is a background promo, background input promo. Okay, amazing. And just give text first, go Angga. Okay, and I think that for the text style has to be different letter. Okay, text color, we have to check in the Adobe HD. This is the same color that, you know, for the primary color. And then we have to give the ID, which is input promo. Okay. And if you see in the design, there's a button here, but there's another that we called hint, use promo code. Okay. And for the text one, we just want to remove it like this. And then text color hint, same color like this. Okay, amazing. So we just want to copy the button from button remove. So over here, I already duplicate the button. I put outside of the linear layout before the constraint layout, okay? So we have to customize again the drawable here. So I go with a background button check promo. Okay. And then we have to paste here from the button here, but we just need to change the color, right? Actually, it's all same. Just change the color here. Okay. And over here, we change text color with white color. Okay. And then this is background check promo. Okay, and then I have to go back to design and put this button the next after input file, sorry, edit text. Okay, like this. I just want to give the margin right, and then give the margin top like this. Okay, and then I just want to put here. Okay, perfecto. Let me decrease. I think just go with 42. No, 44. Yeah, it looks amazing. So let me try into the emulator. So you see that use promo here. Wow, it looks nice, and we could check here. But I think that the button check, it just need to decrease the margin top. So this is supposed to be 43. And then we have to go back to the text, and we're heading here. So for the background, it's different. I just remember it. I'm sorry. So here, the hex code is F8 and F8 and F8. So you will see there's another color behind of this white color. Okay, it looks amazing, right? And let's try again into the emulator. Wow, it's just amazing. Wow, cool, right? And you could use keyboard here, and you could use manually with your like this and check whether the promo code is working or not. Okay, one more thing. So we have to go back to in this section, which was 180. So I'm looking for that. So 180 has to be here. Okay, this one, right? So this one, this is the price title, right? I'm going to duplicate this, and put here, and this is supposed to be not price title, but this is supposed to be discount price. But the problem is if we put here, the layouts become like this. And what if we just use elevation? So it still doesn't working, right? So I think that the thing that we have to do, we couldn't do animation on this section, but we just want to replace the text, okay? So alright, let's get started. So we already give the input promo. Oh sorry, we missing the button. How could Angga? Yeah, this button. Okay, so we have to give another button here. I think that I just want to copy from here and then remove this one. So for the text size, supposed to be 20 SP, and then just make it bigger, maybe like this, and 45 dp. No. If we see in the design, is it has to be 160 dp with 50 dp. 160 dp with 50 dp. Okay. And the text itself is the all caps, supposed to be false, and this is pay no. Okay, and the button has to be pay. Okay, and we're heading to the design, and I have to put here and then put here. Sorry guys, put here and then we put here. I think that the button is just too big. How about we decrease by 40, and for the text size we decrease to the 18 SP. Okay, and then we go back to design, and I have to move to the top like this. Okay, it's enough. Cool. And I'm gonna try into the emulator. So this is the button that I already customized from here. Button check promo and button pay. And this is button pay here. And this is button pay and button check promo. So right now we have to register edit text for input promo, right? So here I just want to cover here. Input promo and paste here and paste, and this is supposed to be edit text. Okay, and then for this one, edit text has to be a regular, I think. So this is supposed to be input promo. Okay, so if you see here, the promo, it's already here. Okay, it looks nice. Okay, so right now, if we click the button check, has to be validate the data that we have. Okay, so here I want to make a public void do check promo like this. Okay, and we have to give string current promo, or I just want to make it shorter. Okay, so the current promo has to be go Angga. Okay, so right now we have to give the validation here if input promo get text to string equals go Angga, and then the total price, or sorry, price title supposed to be set text, supposed to be cheaper, okay, and then discount title set text supposed to be 50%. Okay, and then for layout, okay, I forgot something here. So in this promo layout, in this layout promo, we have linear layout 3, okay? So here, we have to register linear layout and linear layout 3. And then here, I think that I just want to duplicate this. And this is linear layout 3 and linear layout 3. And this is linear layout, okay? So if I click, if the string is equal to the current promo, which is Gogo Angga, or you just need to remove this. And then we make this animate alpha 0 and translation y minus 200. And then set duration 800 and set start delay 100 and start. Okay? And then button pay animate translation y minus 100 and set duration and then set start delay 300 and then start. Okay, so this is the do check promo, but what if the promo code is wrong? So we have to give toss a make text and get application context. Okay. And then after that, coupon is wrong, okay? And toss, length sort, and so, okay? So we got the function to check whether the promo code is working or not, okay? So we have to put here in button check promo, okay? Set on click, new, here, supposed to be do check promo. Okay, let's write here maybe Merdeka we check, coupon is wrong, okay, and maybe Panda sell check, coupon is wrong. What above is we write Gogo Angga check, is working, right? But the problem is the button check hasn't come off, so I think that we just want to put here, so this is for the button. Button check promo, okay? So here has to be capitalized, Gogo Angga, and check, wow, the discount is 50% and the total price has changes to the 20. Wow, cool, right? So this is how you could easily to make the promo code, you know. So this is a Jajan KTI. And try again by Jajan, check, no, so Angga, check, no, and then Gogo Angga, check, it's working, right? So if you have some question in terms of this tutorial, just let me know, because I'm gonna answer to you in the video's comment, alright guys? So hopefully it was useful for you. Okay everyone, with the spirit of learning, I hope that was amazing for you and I hope it was useful for you. So if you think so, please hit that subscribe button and let me grow up by 100,000 subscribers by this year. Okay everyone, with the spirit of learning, I'll see you in the next video someday. Bye.